NLP techniques and training versus coaching? What is the difference? And when would you use each one?
I'm Ruth Kudsey, the founder of Ruth Kudsey Coaching. I transformed my life and my business, and I'm passionate about helping others do the same.
Coaching is very much centered on the client. It's completely non-directional, and you work with the client to get them towards an outcome, a goal, a desire that they want. Pure coaching can go deep. We look at unconscious beliefs. We look at language. We look at our intuition and the energy. So it can be a very, very deep experience. However, in pure coaching, we don't use scripts. We may use tools and techniques with the client's permission. And that kind of bit with tools and techniques really blends with NLP. So NLP, neuro-linguistic programming, it looks at language patterns. It looks at particular scripts and models that help the client actually identify and build a representation in their brain of how they see things. So you can see already there is a bit of a crossover. But some of NLP is more directional. It's not that you're telling somebody what to do, you're not mentoring them. You're going through a set script or a set process. And that is where it's different. So I am an NLP practitioner. I'm partway through my NLP master practitioner, and I'm also a spiral energy coach, which uses NLP. Equally, I'm an MCC, I'm a master coach with the ICF, one of less than 70 in the UK and less than 1,700 worldwide. And that is the highest level you can get in the coaching world. It is the most robust accreditation level across any of these different interventions. But I use both because they're both used in different circumstances. So as I said, pure coaching is brilliant. You can go deep. You can look at unconscious beliefs and you can change them. You can reprogram someone's brain using coaching, building new neural pathways. However, NLP, energy work, spiral, all of this stuff can also be really beneficial to clients. NLP uses the power of suggestion. It uses hypnosis and hypnotic techniques, which are able to help people get into their unconscious. You can also use NLP content free, which means that your client doesn't need to talk about the situation. You're working them through a script and process that helps them see things differently. And it can be really, really effective. So often when people are stuck, maybe with a situation, NLP can help people unlock what is going on in their unconscious, but it is a more directive way. So I'm going to give you an example. You may use a script that helps somebody to look at things in different ways, and you might get the person to move physically around the room and actually step into somebody's shoes. In coaching, you might do that, but you might actually get them to think about other people's views by asking different questions. Now, as you can see, they could both get a similar result. One of them is more scripted, one of them is more client-led, but they're not mentoring, you're not directing with either. NLP, you can also harness the unconscious through things like timeline therapy. And most NLP practitioners are also timeline therapy practitioners like me, which means that you're able to go backwards with a client and really help them to move forward from stuff that has happened in the past. You don't go into the trauma, you don't explore the trauma, but you go to the past to help them with the future. So if somebody is really stuck, if someone isn't moving past things, then NLP can be a great tool to bring in to help them move forward. The same with the energy coaching that I do, which uses a blend of NLP. I would say coaching, forward focused, client led, really looking at what you can do to move forward and going into the past only around the beliefs work. NLP, you look more at the past and uncovering some of those blocks to move forward. Again, we don't go into the trauma. It's not therapy, it's not counseling, but lots of proponents of NLP say because these scripts have been developed, they can really help people to unlock things that were in their unconscious so they can move forward. Lots of great coaches may integrate some NLP into their work. A And I would say that if you're wanting to do that, get professionally trained in NLP. Look out for courses from the ANLP, because it is a different skill set. In pure coaching, we're only using tools and techniques with the client's go ahead. The same with NLP. If we're integrating that into coaching, we need to make sure that the clients have said yes. Lots and lots of people train in elements of NLP. I actually first came across it when I was on a fast track course to become a head teacher, and we looked at some NLP principles and how we could use those in our schools to build better relationships with the young people. Things like rapport and matching, and things like, you know, slowing down your voice if somebody is really, you know, in that high aggressive energy. And this is really interesting, because actually a lot of what NLP was formed on is a growing body of neuroscience that is supporting some of the work of NLP. And as somebody who uses neuroscience in coaching, if you're interested in how the brain works, if you're interested in how we build relationships, then have a look at NLP, have a look at coaching. It's very interesting that a lot of positive psychology, again, you can see the flavors from NLP. So when you're thinking and examining this, it's really about how do we think? And how does how we think impact our relationships? And we can look at that from different viewpoints. We can look at that from, you know, how can we build better relationships? What are the tools that we can use that will help us to build better relationships? Whether that be in the workplace, whether that be selling, whether that be personally. And this is sometimes where NLP gets a bad rep, because some of the tools that we can use to build better relationships can also be seen as using to manipulate in sales. And this is why I would say, when we're using any of these techniques, use them ethically. People in the NHS, people in businesses, train their staff in NLP to help them build relationships in an ethical way. Because it is about this awareness of language and language patterns and how we can use that differently. If you've got any interest in politicians and speeches, if you have a look at these, you'll notice that often they use NLP techniques. They may make generalizations. Everybody, all of us. They may go very, very big, or they may chunk things down when they're speaking. So NLP can be a fascinating area to look at, because it really, you can start to see how it applies to all of our relationships in everyday life. And you can also look at the elements of NLP that do have support from neuroscience, that do really talk about how these processes work in the brain. So if you are interested, I would recommend that you start to read some books, you start to look at people like Richard Bandler, who started NLP. And this is distinctive to coaching, which can include NLP elements. So some coaches may be trained in NLP, some may use elements of it. But really, it's about understanding on a neurological level in our brains, what is going on? How do we think? How do we make decisions? How do we decide who we like and who we don't like? What is going on there? And if we want to build better relationships, how can that self-awareness enable us to do so? So how could you use NLP? Imagine a friend comes to you, and I'm not recommending you coach a friend, but a friend comes to you and they've had a falling out with another friend, and they believe that they are completely right and they are distraught. So how would you do that with NLP? Well, what you do is you help the person who's come to you see things from the viewpoint of their friend. You help them build a mental model of what is going on for the friend. So how can you do that? Well, there are techniques that you can do that where you move the person around the room and you get them to look and stand in the shoes of the other person. So you can get them to stand in the shoes of their friend. You can get them to stand in the shoes of an observer. You can even get them to stand in your shoes. And by doing that, they're able to see and able to realize that their perspective is their perspective, and there may be other things going on. That always gets aha moments, because often we're in our head and we are internalizing what is going on. This helps you get out of your head and realize that there are different things that are going on for different people. And that can be a way of moving forward. From a coaching approach, you've got someone who comes and they want to work on their relationship with their friend. And what you can do is you can help them to understand through questioning what is really going on for them, to unpick why this is impacting them. And again, you can use questions to help them to see the situation differently and to help them find a way forward. So as you can see, both of the situations give clarity. Coaching focuses on a way forward. You often will get actions from doing that NLP exercise to help people move forward. So it's really about getting people out of their heads. Whether you do that in a way where you're getting people to move around or looking at different models or different scripts, or whether you do that through talking, listening, tapping into energy, tapping into intuitions. They can both get a great result. And that result is making sure that the person realizes the options that are available and can see things from different viewpoints. The next video is up here, but before you go, remember to subscribe, like, and comment with anything else that you'd like to see from me.